Before you land a job, you need to get the interview. To get that, you need a great resume and application. We'll get you started on perfecting these skills in this video. Some of the most critical tasks of your job search are, in fact, creating your resume and completing an application. How you display your education and experience can make or break the chance at nailing a job interview. So let's make sure you look as awesome on your resume and application as you are in person. We already know there's a good amount of competition out there. So how do you impress employers? You'll learn the information to include on your resume, what format to use, and how to submit it. Following these tips can boost your resume to the top of the search pile in a future employer's inbox. While there are a few specifics that need to be included in your resume, tailoring it to each specific job you're applying for is the best approach. Carefully read the job description for the position you want, then compare the qualifications required to the skills and experience you have. Basically, there are three parts to a resume: skills and accomplishment summary, education, and experience or work history. The skill summary section is where you can really shine, include a wide array of things you're awesome at. But let's leave out that time you won that hot dog eating contest, or when you were nominated prom king or queen. Those aren't exactly the accomplishments future employers are looking for. So stick to the skills and accomplishments that relate to the job you're applying for and that you're most proud of. Highlight professional skills, like communication skills, leadership skills, and work ethic. And then get specific. If a job needs specific computer skills, highlight the skills you have and the software you are proficient at using. If there's specific equipment you've used that pertains to the job, point that out. In addition to skills, you can list accomplishments. Provide an example of what you've contributed to a past job or an organization you belong to. Again, be specific and be positive. You're the best person that can tell your own story. You know what you have to offer a potential employer. So toot that horn, ring that bell, shout it from the mountaintops. Let them know how well you organized the files in your last job, how you raised money for the marching band, how you handled multiple tasks all at the same time, that you were employee of the month, or that you were the president of your high school Make-A-Wish Foundation chapter. We all know the saying, less is more, and that can be a valuable tip with resume writing. Showcase your talents without overselling yourself. Choose the most significant and relevant leadership experiences that you've had. Don't be afraid to cut things that may not apply. Key point here, whatever your special skills are to be included in your resume, they need to be relevant to the job opening you're applying for. Another section you need to include in your resume is your education history. The highest level of education you've completed should be listed, including the school you attended and the type of degree you received or will receive. In addition, if you've taken technical classes, specialty seminars, or attended vocational schools, include it. Listing additional education, certification, and training will show your employers you've worked to develop your skills. Now, let's say your education history isn't the most important piece of what you'll bring to the table for an employer. The experience section of your resume is where you can show how your past experience has prepared you for this job. Previous jobs, internships, apprenticeships, volunteer work, and leadership roles should all be listed and described in detail here. Having experience proves to an employer that you are able to create successful outcomes in real-world scenarios. When you're just starting in the job market, your experience may look like this. The important thing here is to point out that you've grown in these jobs and what you've learned. Working at a car wash, you became a self-starter, increased sales, and learned how to take care of customers, right? These are important skills that help illustrate your work ethic and willingness to do what is needed to get the job done. All of these jobs make you who you are today, a valuable potential employee. And as you grow your work history, you can cut out a relevant job experience that can cloud up your resume and be a distraction from what's really important. Be proud of the summer you spent wearing a hot dog suit at Big Dave's Dogs. Your location was number one in sales that summer, and you played a part in that. Don't get discouraged if your resume doesn't seem to have a great deal of experience on it. We all had to start somewhere, and employers understand that. However, one of the worst things you can do on the job search is to misrepresent yourself on your resume. The Economic Times recently published a study that highlights the results of job seekers actually lying on resumes. The findings are astonishing. Over 80% of companies reported that they have caught job candidates misrepresenting themselves. It may be tempting to exaggerate facts or hide a work gap on your resume, but portraying yourself accurately and honestly is always the better choice. Credibility and truthfulness always pay off. On to discussing the formats you can use to organize your resume. Choose the one that works best for you depending on which areas you want to showcase. A chronological format is set up like a timeline, listing the most recent employment first. This places more emphasis on jobs held over specific skills and abilities. Work history or experience comes first, then education history. Another format is a functional resume, which focuses on skills and achievements. This works well when you are new to the workforce, for instance. The resume is organized by skill. List your job and education under each skill you are highlighting. A combination format includes skills and achievements like the functional resume, and it includes the chronological format's work history timeline that employers prefer. It's the best of both formats combined. This is the most common format, and it allows for the most flexibility in order to highlight your strong points. Whichever format you choose, proofreading is a vital step. A careless grammar mistake could cause your chances of landing an interview to disappear. So spend some time with this document that you've worked hard putting together. Read and reread your resume to check for misspelled words or incorrect grammar. After that, ask a friend or a family member to proofread it as well. Make sure they're a good speller, though. Check that all your contact information is clearly stated in the header and that it is accurate and professional. ilovekittens@hotmail.com may still be a valid email address you utilize, but make sure the email address you are using during your job search is professional and does not jeopardize your image, even if you do love kittens. Simply using the format firstnamelastname@gmail.com works perfectly. Hiring managers read very similar resumes over and over again. Most resumes use the same lingo when describing skills for that job posting. So how can you set yours apart and stand out? With soft skills. Soft skills are your people skills. They are the abilities, attitudes, and habits you have that help you relate and interact with other people. There's more information about soft skills in the Job Genius Selecting a Career Path video. The top soft skills employers are looking for are a strong work ethic, a positive attitude, and good communication skills. So how do you convince a potential employer you have these skills? Use the right words. When proofreading, go in and see where you can swap a few words. Here are some examples of words you can use to showcase yourself. Examples of words that convey work ethic: diligent, consistent, thoughtful, accurate, valuable, thorough, reliable, results, persistence, and improved. Examples of words that convey positive attitude: solutions, vision, success, encouraged, innovative, achieved, motivated, contributed, collaborated, and outcome. Examples of words that convey communication skills: spoke, presented, published, negotiated, inspired, created, shared, timely, and concise. All of these words can be used to describe your job functions and skills on your resume. Don't use them all. Pick the ones that describe you best. After proofreading and revising your resume, you'll want to save it in the format that has been requested. Some employers prefer a Microsoft Word document, while others will ask for a PDF. It is wise to have two versions of your resume saved in these different formats so you can be ready to send it in a moment's notice. If you are sending your resume through an applicant tracking system, you will definitely need to submit your resume as a Microsoft Word document or a rich text form. Applicant tracking systems are used by employers to manage job openings. However, according to CIO Magazine, these systems discard approximately 75% of submitted resumes. For example, if you incorporate the wrong word or phrase or format incorrectly, your resume may not be selected for review. Here's some tips to keep that from happening to you. Use the same language found in the job description. Identify industry terms, buzzwords, and jargon in the description. Use standard formatting. Keep your resume neat by incorporating plenty of white space. Stick to standard fonts like Arial or Lucinda. Avoid charts, graphs, and symbols. Use a relatable name. You want to save your resume with a file name that is useful and meaningful to the hiring manager. First name and last name work every time, just like your email address. These tips may not get you the job, but they will ensure you get a chance to get the job. Resumes can certainly take a lot of time to put together, but they play a big role in whether or not you'll land an interview. So take your time. After all, you are more than what is on your resume. But step one is to convince your employers of that. By proofreading and tailoring it each time, you'll be able to prove that you're a great candidate for that specific open job. your resume is ready, and you've found a job opening that interests you. You will most likely be asked to complete an application even if you have already submitted your resume. The application becomes the official record of your personal, education, and employment history. It is signed and verified by you, the applicant. Just like your resume, it is important for your applications to be complete and accurate. Here's the information you will need to complete an application for employment. Your personal information, like name, phone number, and email address. Your education information, including graduation dates and diplomas, degrees, or certificates earned. List the most recent first. The title of position you're applying for, the hours you're available, and when you can start. Past and current employment information, including the names, supervisors' names, addresses, and phone numbers, salary, and reason for leaving from all previous employment. List your most recent job first. Oh, and all the contact information for three references. This includes the person's name, job title or relationship, email address, and phone number for each one. These don't necessarily need to be work-related. If you have volunteered, you can use members of the organizations that you have helped, or if you're a student, use your teachers. In all cases, ask for permission prior to using the person for reference. Just a few more tips about completing a job application. Complete all requested information. Don't leave anything blank. If you don't know the details, bring the application home and return it when it's completed. If it's a printed application, write clearly and neatly using black or blue ink. Check for spelling and grammatical errors. Proofread your application before turning it in. Don't forget to sign it if required. You didn't think we'd get through this video without more homework, did you? Review sample resumes and job applications. Print one or two out and review and complete them so you know you have all the information ready to represent yourself the best you can. Practice makes perfect, and if anything can be perfect, it's your resume. The Job Genius Education Series is presented by Express Employment Professionals. Visit expresspros.com to learn more. Jump on board. Your future awaits. You've written your resume, you've applied for the job, so what could possibly come next? Yikes, it's the interview. No worries, Job Genius walks you through the process in the video, Job Genius, the interview.